The Java Collections Framework is a set of interfaces and classes that make it easy to manage data collections in your applications. You can manage either ordered or unordered data, and you can use one of four categories of classes. Each of these categories is represented by an interface. On this page, they're shown in the far left column, and they're named Set, List, DQ, and Map. And then, across the top, you'll see the different types of collections within the categories. So, for example, let's say you wanted to create a list. A list is ordered data, and you wanted it to be resizable. You might then select the ArrayList class. Now, when you declare a collection object, it's traditional to set the type of the collection as the interface. And then, when you instantiate the object, you use a constructor method for the concrete class that you want to use. So let's start in this project where the main method is empty, but I have a single object called clothing item. I'm going to start by creating a list that contains strings. Using collections will also introduce you to the concept of generics. Generic syntax makes the use of collections type safe. That is, you can trust that the items in a collection are of a particular type. If I want to create a list of strings, I would start with what's known as the diamond operator, and then I'd declare the type of the items within the list in the diamond. Now, the list interface has to be imported. I'll move the cursor after the identifier and press Control Space, and I'll choose List from java.util. I'll name my list States. Next, I'll initialize it with New, and then I have to use a constructor method from one of the concrete classes. I couldn't, for example, say I wanted to create a new list. Interfaces don't have constructors. So instead, I might use ArrayList. And that's all there is to it. Now, in older versions of Java, you would have also had to declare the type of the items in the list in the diamond operator in the constructor. So you might have done something like this. But that's no longer necessary. Starting in Java 7, you can eliminate the secondary declaration. And in fact, IntelliJ IDEA shows you that that type is dimmed out, and when I use an intention action, it offers to replace that with just the diamond operator. Now, the ArrayList is a resizable array, so now I can add as many items as I want. Use the syntax states.add, and then I'll pass in a string. I'll pass in California. Then I'll duplicate that line a few times, and for the second one, I'll use Oregon. And for the third one, I'll use Washington. Then, as I did before with the array, I'll use a for each loop. And then, each item in the list is a string. I'll call it state, and I'll get these values from the states collection. And then I'll output the current state. And there's the result. The items are stored in the order in which I declared them. Let's say now that you wanted to create a list of numeric values. You might try something like this. List with a type of int, but that won't work. The items within a collection must be objects, not primitives. So if you want to create a list of numeric values, you would use the helper class. I'll use integer. I'll call the list int for integers, and I'll instantiate it using exactly the same syntax as before. I'll start adding numeric values. Then I'll do a loop using the for each syntax. For each integer within the loop, I'll output it to the console. And again, the data is stored in the order in which I declared it. If I want to remove an item, I can do it easily using a method of the list interface called remove. So for example, I'll use states.remove, and I'll pass in a value of 1. And remember that indexing starts at 0 in Java, so that really means remove the second item. And when I run the code now, my list still contains the first and third item, but the third item is now the second item. If I want to retrieve an item in a particular location, I can use a method of the list interface called get. I'll create a string called state, and I'll get its value with states.get, and then I'll pass in a value of 1. And then I'll output the second state is, and then I'll append state. And there's the result. The second state is Washington. And if I want to find a particular item in the list, I can do that with a method of the list interface called indexOf. I'll declare an integer that I'll name POS for a position, and I'll get its value with states.indexOf, and I'll pass in a value of Washington. And then I'll output the string, Washington is at position, and then I'll output that variable. There are many more methods you can use in the list interface. I'll click into the list identifier and press Shift F1, and that takes me to the documentation. Then I'll go down to the method list, and you'll see all sorts of things you can do to add, remove, inspect, and otherwise manipulate lists of data.